You still know how to work that thing?
No.
Okay. So, we are back. Kind of. Not really sure for how long. The video you guys are about to watch was filmed back in March. I don't even know how many months it is. Six, seven, I don't know. 10. During the time that we've been gone, we've done a lot of stuff. But I've actually filmed a couple of videos that have not been released yet. And I kind of apologize. As you can see, Meg is still in one piece. We got another surprise right here that will come in another video. The black truck's still all together. This video that you're about to watch is about our trailer that we've used for what events have we gone to? Diesel New York, UCC, Atlantic City. We're going to be using it for a lot of stuff, and we're really excited to show you guys. We're glad to be back. Really glad to show you guys the new purchases. We got a couple new ones, a couple more than I'd like to admit. So enjoy the video. I'll see you guys back, and we'll go give a complete overview of the trailer that we bought. So I'll see you in about, I don't know, 10 seconds. All right, so the Meg's in here. We're putting in the gooseneck hitch. Turns out this truck has a fifth wheel attachment. Right now we're taking out all the fifth wheel attachments. There's four pins. Or four attachments that the pin's going to. Screwing up the bed liner right now.
That's fine.
Old fancy Milwaukee impact here that is still struggling to take out these rusted bolts down here. I'm assuming this hitch has been in here since 2013 when the truck was made, or somewhere around that time. That owner hauled about 55,000 miles with this truck, so they've probably been in here for a while, but this brake bar is doing the trick. If Josh trips out this bolt, we're gonna be in trouble.
Pull it towards you.
Oh yeah.
There we go. Oh yeah.
Smells like a birthday cake. See, Josh was doing it wrong. You gotta get fucking in there, get out, let the bed cool down. We got a huge life update. Not really a life update, but like a overall garage update for you guys. Mega's up here getting some work done. If you guys have been following the whole Mega cab build, last video we did on the old girl here, we took it from completely bone stock to what it is right now, which is like a perfect ultimate daily driver. Tune deleted, nil 420 V's with 24x12, especially forged masterpieces. Pretty much bought this whole truck to do all the heavy lifting, the hard work, the dirty work, everything except for salt. So I haven't driven this since we went to Motorama, which was about a month ago. I cannot wait to show you guys what we got in the back there, because it's something that I have always wanted. I say it a lot, but hey, we're checking off ticks on the bucket list week after week, which is awesome. We got a big old B&W gooseneck hitch. We installed it for the past two nights. 2 5/16 inch gooseneck ball hitch, reversible. There's a pin on this side over here on the driver's side. So up underneath here, there's a pin. This goes up underneath the truck, of course. Pull this, it locks in place, and then release it. And then you can flip that ball to pretty much nothing. You can make the bed flush. What happens is this ball can come out. It's locked in right now, but this ball can flip out and slide down in there flush with the bed. So if you do have to put anything in here, it's flush, it's not in the way. We do have some cleaning up to do. Of course, the shop is a mess. I put our exhaust back on because that elbow and that side exit should go right there. Right now, it's pretty much a cab dump up underneath there. I put that on real quick, no big deal. Then we gotta do a oil change. Show you guys something. If you guys haven't seen this, I found this at Motorama. Oil filter spider thing, it down, grips a hold of oil filter like that, loosen up. Goes the other way and grips it like that. Next day, we got the Mega Cab out here ready to go. We're going to pick up a 32-foot. It's not a deck over. It's actually the defenders are actually drive over. I'm not really sure what they call them, but like low boy kind of thing. Iron bolt 32-foot gooseneck trailer. Like I said, we got about a 4-hour drive, and then picking up the trailer and then coming back.
The sound of breaking down.
CDL, GVWR, and the whole thing is about 24,000 pounds with the truck and trailer combo that we got on here. I'll go over that a little bit more when we get parked up after we get home. As you can see back there, the trailer is hauling perfect. It is a heck of a lot different than a bumper pull trailer, so that is going to take some time to get used to for sure. So we'll go over the whole setup and exactly what the trailer is, or as far as what I know about it, when we get back home. But for now, the good old Mega is hauling perfectly, but we got about an hour left to go, and then we're gonna park it up. I don't know if I'll be able to talk to you guys later tonight or tomorrow, but I'll see ya. I'll see you when I see ya. Overview of this trailer, saying that we've been using it for the past all summer pretty much. A bunch of stuff with it. We've hauled trucks. Pretty much only trucks. A lot of variety in trucks, you know what I mean? So we hauled my burnout truck multiple times with it. We hauled the Bill, the black truck, and Razor at the same time. It's probably the heaviest load that I've had on the truck, which I think that equal out to around 8,000 pounds, give or take, maybe 8,500, 9,000 pounds. I don't really know. I don't have a scale here. Dude, come here. Whoever's out there hating, saying that you can't haul on skinny tires, it's been happening. It's been happening. We didn't just start. It's more of a lifestyle than anything. So they've really been doing good. To be fair, they have worn down. I'd say we're about 65% tread. I have about 7,000 miles on the tires. They've been doing pretty good. Plus, I haven't rotated them like I'm supposed to. And you know, the mega cab gets down. So, you know, I feel like having a heavy foot, I mean, those tires take all that abuse also. So, as far as the truck goes, especially these tires, B&W hits that I showed you guys us putting on, everything as far as that goes is really nice. Now, the gooseneck was a big decision on my part. A, it looks awesome. I think out of a fifth wheels don't really look that cool. Fifth wheels, bumper pulls, and goosenecks look, they look like they mean business. They look like they can haul a lot, and honestly, they're really good for your truck, suspension, transmission, tire, payload, everything. They're really, really nice. It's a 2020. We bought it with 600 miles on it. The previous owner said he bought it brand new in 2020, pretty much parked it. And I kind of believe him, saying that the tires are brand new. Everything's up to date. The chains are still gold on the thing. Budget was slightly limited. You know, I don't have $30,000 to just go buy a brand new Diamond C custom order, whatever. It's all black powder coat. This is not a painted trailer, so it doesn't suffer your chips, your rust, any other normal stuff you get at a trailer from Tractor Supply or something like that. I've owned this trailer for like 6 months, and I kind of put on myself that there isn't a winch on there yet, but there isn't. I don't really know what to say. thing. So there are plans for the trailer, believe it or not. Stain the wood on top, do rock lights, winches, rock lights up here to shine on the load. I have two. I'll only undo one of these for you guys, because, you know, you'll get the idea. Pretty much flip up. You can readjust this bracket here. Here's a brace that kind of connects this little pin slot here, and you can have them load up like that if you really need to extend your load all the way out. If not, they can lay flat, but yeah, they're all spring loaded as it should be. I'll take the camera real quick here. This is the issue with the trailer as a whole. Pretty much the only vehicles that haven't had an issue getting up on here are those two right there. Everything else is a slight suffer to get up on here because of the loading angle of this trailer. It's kind of hard to see, but I would say that's probably a 30 to 35% grade right there. Inconvenient for our Dakotas, any other normal car out there, and anything that's either not lifted or has a really high approach angle to it. I went and bought this trailer in Connecticut. I drove 4 hours for it. When I got there, these ramps were kind of a little bit steeper than I was expecting. So we'll stand back here. It's a pretty long trailer. I got the wide angle on. There we go. It's still long in this application of the camera lens here. The reason I wanted to do this trailer, a lot of people do the deck overs. I like the deck overs. They were definitely a big factor when considering buying a trailer like this. With being how tall, we have plans in the future to make the black truck and possibly other lifted trucks or just doing anything. Pretty much. We really wanted to keep the deck as low as possible because you're probably saving a good 6 to 8 inches on those drive over fenders. There's a dirt bike. It's kind of why we went with drive over ramps. And plus it fits the bill perfect. The tires go right up over top of the ramps. As you can see, the Mega is sitting hard. All right guys, so that is pretty much it. I've been waiting a long time to do this review. Happy to have this trailer. Like I said, we've gotten some pretty good use out of it so far. It's going to be with us for probably a decently long time. Probably as long as we had the Mega Cab, we'll have this trailer. Never owned a Gooseneck. Nobody in my family's ever owned a Gooseneck. And before buying this and picking up, purchasing it from the guy in Connecticut, I've never even driven with a Gooseneck. So that was the first time I've ever hooked up to a Gooseneck. And it drives way different than a bumper pull, but regardless, it pulls really nice, especially with all the heavy weight on it. It's really a top-rated trailer. The whole setup is within our CDL limit, which is 26,000 pounds. This whole GVWR setup for this trailer and truck combo is 24,500 pounds. We are just under it, and in that case, that makes it perfect for what we're doing. It may not be perfect for what you're doing. I might have clickbaited this video just a tad bit, being the perfect trailer. There is no perfect trailer for everyone. Everybody has a different case. I understand that. For what we're doing, it is perfect for now until, you know, we get another truck or we need to haul two trucks. Then we start running into space limitations. That's it for now. Really glad you guys, if you're watching this, I'm really glad you guys are still with us. Just surpassed 3,000 subscribers probably like a week or two ago. We got a couple videos. We got Diesel New York video coming up for you guys soon. We got a video on the side-by-side. We got UCC and Atlantic City video. And we also bought another truck that's not here currently that also will have its own video. It's been a heck of a summer that you guys haven't been around for. And I apologize for that, but we'll get back to normal here soon, hopefully, maybe. And I'll see you in the next one. See ya.